Hi, welcome to myprojectprasad.com. Now let me discuss about the title of the process. Our title is Efficient Attribute Based Comparable Data Access Control. Now let me discuss about the objective of the process. The main objective of the process is to present an novel range elevation function for comparative attribute based encryption. In this, we construct a CCP-CABE framework with a central trust authority and further extend it to PCCP-CABE to fit the scenario with multiple attribute domains. Now did we discuss about the abstract of our process. With the proliferation of mobile devices in recent years, there is a growing concern regarding secure data storage, secure computation and fine-grained access control in data sharing. From this resource constraint devices in a cloud environment. So in this work, we propose a new efficient framework name that is called CCP, that is named as a constant size ciphertext policy comparative attribute based encryption. With the support of negative attributes and wildcards. It embeds the comparable attribute ranges of all the attributes into the user's key and incorporates the attribute constraints of all the attributes into the one piece of ciphertext during the encryption process to enforce flexible access control policies with various range relationships. Accordingly, CCP-CAB achieves efficiency because it generates a constant size keys and ciphertext regardless of the number of involved attributes, and it also keeps the computation cost constant on lightweight mobile devices. We further discuss how to extend CCP-CABE to fit a scenario with multiple attribute domains, such as the decryption procedure from the least confidential attribute domain to the most confidential one to help protect the privacy of access policy. We provide security analysis and performance evaluation to demonstrate the efficiency of the end. Now let me discuss about the error code diagram of process. First, user starts with user login. After user enters into the system, a user must get the attributes and send that attributes to the key generator. Key generator by using the particular user attributes. Here we are using how to generate that master key. So here we are applying some algorithm called CCCP algorithm for generating the attribute based keys. Then after we generate the keys, here we have to input the information and send it to the user. And then here we are using algorithm called DES algorithm. Then that information has been stored in a database. After when a particular receiver enters into the environment, he or she submits a query. By using that particular query, here we retrieve the resources. So the resources will be in encrypted format. So for decryption, here we are going to apply the DES algorithm, and by using that attribute based keys only, here we have to encrypt the decrypt that particular information. So this is the complete data flow diagram of our process. Now let me discuss about the complete data flow diagram of our process. First, we have to run home.java. First, I click and then run file. The home page will be opened here. Will open here. Then our type of the process is efficient attribute based comparable data access control. Then here use service request registration layer. So if you are already a member, you have to sign in the paper. If you are new, you have to sign up. So click sign up. So you just enter here, update your profile. Here is a profile generation and authentication of users. So enter your name, then enter your mail ID, then enter your password, then here get your unique ID, then click next button. So here get an ID and name, then send these attributes to key generator for generating the keys. So here you have to run generate keys.java in key generation package. So these attributes will be forwarded to key generator. So just click receive and click send to key generator. That information will be received here. So click generate, key 1 and key 2 will be generated based upon this user attributes. Taking care, we are generating a key for encryption and send the particular key to user, receive key and click send key. So key for encryption has been ready for here, for encryption. So then click next button. So you have to collect your data. So this is something, a person data shares. So here we have a person information, patient information. Then click next. So here we are encrypting the particular information based on that particular key, attribute based key. So here we encrypt the particular user information by using that particular key and the AES algorithm. Then here after that you have, if a receiver enters into the process, then run query submission and query retrieval package. So here you have to enter your query, then gate, and after that you have to receive your key for decrypting the results, and then you have to send that particular key to user, receive key and send user's key to. And here we retry and decrypt the result. So this is an encrypted text, this is a decrypted text. Decrypted details will be described here. So this is a complete demo of process. Thank you for watching.